I'm James Taylor, and this is Female Head Modeling for Animation in Maya 2016. Let's start by taking a look at the finished topology. When it comes to animating the head, we have two key areas, the eyes and the mouth. For the mouth, we have the laugh line that encircles the entire area and determines a lot of animation that happens there. The eye area is a bunch of concentric rings. It's a little bit simpler. The real trick is getting these two areas to blend together. Now to start off, I'm going to import head-specific image planes. And with these head image planes, we need them to be extremely high resolution so that we can make out what we're doing. So you'll see that I can import more than one set of image planes into each viewport, and I'm just going to match up my new head image planes with the existing body image planes. Once my image planes are set up, I'm ready to start creating the head. So I'll build a cylinder and I'll set it so that it has 8 subdivisions on its axis. I'll rotate it towards me and then I'll position that right on the center of the eye. I'll create another cylinder. This is going to be the mouth. I'll set this to have 12 subdivision axes and I'll center this right on the middle of the lips. So with those cylinders, I'll grab all the faces that aren't the front caps and I'll just delete those. You'll see that I lined them up a little bit on the side view reference. I'll also delete half of the mouth and then I'll combine these two objects together and duplicate special. And I'm gonna start by editing the eye. I'm gonna shrink the eye verts all the way down and I'm gonna position this right along the edges of the whites of the eyes. And I'll line that up in both the front and the side views. Then I'll delete those interior edges and I'll just connect up to down so that I have a bunch of vertical rows. And then I'll just grab that outside row and extrude it out. I'll pull this next row outwards and it's going to be the outer edge of the eyelid, so where the eyelid folds back into the head. But on the bottom, we don't really have any lines to go on, so we're just going to keep it relatively close to the eyeball. And I'll just tweak these verts. I do want to keep them in relatively vertical rows, the same way that I did with the eyeball itself. Now from the side view, all of these verts will sit a little bit behind the verts that they correspond to on the eyeball area. So this whole set of edges is basically going to come back a little bit. And then I'll grab that set of edges, I'll extrude that out, and this row here is going to be the orbit around the eye. So placing the upper edge of this row is pretty easy. We're going to line up those top three verts along the eyebrow that's going to sit along that brow ridge. We're going to have to bring in the outside verts here. The inside vert on the corner sits on the bridge of the nose. It doesn't meet in the center. And the verts below stick pretty close to the overall eye. And then when I'm adjusting things in the side view, the eyebrow again provides a pretty clear reference for what we need to do. The rest of it, we kind of have to guess, and a lot more of it will become clear as we work on the rest of the head. And one last step here, I'll just select all of the edges and soften those edges. And then I'll harden the edges around the eye and above the eyelid to add some clarity. And then I'll turn my attention to the mouth. With the outer row, this is the laugh line. And the key to positioning it is this vert right here. I want to make sure that it hooks above the nostril. That's where the laugh line begins. And then I'm going to move the rest of the shape around in kind of a teardrop shape around her face. We should be able to see the laugh line visible on our image reference. And then in the side view, I'll move that around. Again, we should be able to see the laugh line pretty clearly in the side view reference. Up next, I want to add the lips. So to do that, I'm going to go to edge mode and select all the edges on the interior of the mouth and use my connect components. So shift right click and then find connect components in there. That'll add a whole new edge row and I'll match those very literally up with the edges of the lip. And similar to the eye, I'm going to get rid of these diagonal lines. Note that I'm leaving the middle line present and I'm going to use my multi-cut tool to connect up to down. I'll use these new verts to match up the center row of the lips. Now I can tackle the side view. So the center two verts are really easy to place. They go out to the edges of the reference. These next two verts are critical. They're almost as far forward as that center row. We need to make sure that we get that curvature. The corner of the mouth will be pretty easy to place. We can see it very literally. That third row is going to be slightly difficult to place, and typically I find myself placing that in the 3D view. So I'll look at it and I'll pull it forward so that I get some nice curvature there. And you'll see I've also softened and hardened the edges on the lips the way that I did with the eyes. Up next, I'm going to add the chin. I'm going to start to fill out the rest of the face. So on edge mode, I'll select the bottom two edges on the mouth and I'll extrude those straight down. And then in the front view, I'll match those up to the chin. And the side view, we'll pull it back. We won't be able to get the curvature of the chin yet. We're not going to worry about that right now. Then I'll extrude that edge out, and this is going to define the edge of our jawline. We really want this nice straight diagonal line because we want our jawline to be defined really strongly along the jawbone itself. And then I'll go to edge mode and I'll grab the two edges for the jaw that I've just added and use connect components to add a subdivision in there, just to add a little bit of curvature that we can see on the image reference. And then I'll do the same thing with that second set of verts on the jaw. I'll just add another set of subdivisions there. This time I'll use the insert edge loop tool and I'll extrude the resulting edge straight up. Those verts are really easy to match up in the side view. On the front view, they're a little bit obscured by her hair, so we're gonna have to kind of guess at it. Now I want to start filling in the cheek. So I'm going to grab these three edges on the bottom of the eye and extrude them straight down. And these verts we can place most easily in the side view. So I'm pushing them back and away from the bottom of the eye. And then I'll grab these two edges and bridge them together. So now I'm connecting the jaw to the cheek slash eye area. And I can do the same thing vertically. So I'll grab the bottom three edges and the top three edges, and I can just bridge across between all of those, and I'll end up filling in the cheek. Now I do need another set of rows, so I'll use my insert edge loop tool to add a new row, and then that resulting vert I'll merge to the corner of the mouth. Okay, so we can see that we have a big gap that looks like a triangle. I'm gonna use my multi-cut tool and cut around the mouth like so. And I'll use my collapse edge function to get rid of that one triangle at the bottom. And then I'm just gonna delete this face here and use my bridge again to connect across. And now I'm getting rid of those triangles one by one. And you'll see that I pulled those verts on the chin up, and I've got a triangle down here that I'm just gonna select and delete. And then I'll extrude the bottom two edges on the chin down. And I'll merge that to the corner vert that we have there. And now I've got nice quads at the bottom of the face. And I've also got that extra detail that I needed to start to actually represent the curvature of the chin. The next thing that I want to do is fill in that central area by adding the nose. I'll start by bridging these two edges together. My next step is to grab the two edges on the center here and connect components or multi-cut to connect them. You'll see I reposition them to kind of roughly match the shape of the nose in the front view. And then I'm going to grab the face that results from that and extrude it straight outwards. I'll grab the face on the top of that extrusion and I'll extrude that straight up. Now we're creating the bridge of the nose up here. I do have some faces behind the shapes I just created. I want to make sure to get rid of those before I go any further. I'll go into vertex mode next, and I'll adjust the points on the bridge of the nose. And the outermost point on the bridge of the nose, you'll see that I match up with that point on the outside of the eye there. Then I could just use merge verts on those points, and I'll go and look at these points in the side view, and I'll just match it up to the reference in the side view. And now I can work on the bulb of the nose, and I'll have to pull these points pretty far forward to match up to my reference. I'll also need to pull these points in fairly closely to the center line. We'll end up with a fairly narrow shape, and that's what we want at this point in time. Now the next thing that we're gonna do is gonna seem a little counterproductive. We're gonna go into face mode. We're gonna grab these faces here and delete them. So we're left with only these faces at the bottom and the bridge of the nose. I'll match that bottom face to the bottom of the nose and I'll extrude out from the tip of it. So I'm gonna bridge from the bottom nose to the edge above it. And then I'm gonna connect these two verts here and I'll delete the resulting triangle. This is gonna create some space for the nostril. I'll start with this edge here. I'll extrude it up twice and I'll kind of curve it around in both the front and the side views. Next, I'll just bridge these two edges here from the front up onto the nostril, and then I'll grab all these edges going around and use connect components to add another set of subdivisions. And I'll just grab that set of edges on the nostril itself, pull those backwards and out a little bit, and now we start to see the roundness of the nostril forming. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and add the actual holes to the nostril. I'll just go into face mode and grab these faces on the bottom and extrude them in place and just kind of shrink them. And I'll move them up a little bit I'll grab those same faces again, the one that we just extruded inwards, and I'll extrude them up to create the actual depth for the nostril. Now I'm going to go to back to the bridge of the nose, and I'm going to grab the two edges on the bridge and extrude them straight back. I'll use my scale tool to flatten them, and then I'll just kind of fit them into the space that's already there. I'll snap that uppermost point to the corner of the eye the way that I did before, and I'll snap that lowermost point onto the corner of the nostril, and I'll just pull this middle point out a little bit. Now, we are going to need to add some subdivisions in here. Once the middle of the nose is positioned correctly, I can grab these two edges and use bridge to close them up, and I'll bridge the next set of edges below as well. And then I just want to collapse that bottom edge on that bridge I just made, so I'm merging those two verts together. That'll leave us with a triangle. We'll resolve it in a second. I'll start doing that by grabbing these two edges and connecting them together, and then just moving that edge up a little bit. I'll connect the next two edges in row as well, and I'll snap the bottommost verts of those down to the nostrils so that we're closing up that hole. I'll just merge all the verts in the area together, and now I can worry about that triangle there. I'll merge those two verts at the top together, and I'll just delete the cross edge, and now we've got a quad. Now we need to deal with the opening next to the nostril, which is kind of triangular in shape. Technically, we could fill it, and it's a quad, but it's not really, it's a little bit too sharp. Now, if I wanted to add subdivisions here, I could just continue the line from the nostril outwards. However, I want to keep things as simple as possible. So I'm gonna grab those edges around the edge of the nostril and delete those edges, so Control Delete. I'll grab these two verts here and connect those. I'll grab this vert and merge it to the vert next to it, and then I'll just delete that diagonal edge. Everything's quadded out. Now I've got to take care of the triangle on the outside of the nostril. So I'm going to grab the edge at the bottom of that triangle and then the two next to it using my multi-cut. Then I'll grab this edge right here and collapse that together. And we'll see that we have all quads and we still have a nice flow that creates the laugh line right where we need it. Now I hit 3 to go into smooth proxy mode and I'm making changes to the anatomy of the face. Since we did reduce some of the geometric complexity in this area, we are going to have to massage the verts in the corner of the nostril to get the proper kind of overlapping shape we need. So I'm pushing that edge back a little bit into the face to create some of that crease where the laugh line sits. Now I do have these two triangles that I want to take care of under the nose, so I'll grab these two edges and connect them. That'll turn both of them into a quad, and it'll allow me to create a little bit more shape under the nose. And now I'm going to switch over to the lips. So the first thing that I'm going to do here is I'm going to zoom in on this edge here and use Add Division to Edge to put a single point in there. And that'll convert the two triangles at the corner of the mouth into a quad. It's also going to give us a better lip shape. And in order to hold the shape of the lips a little bit better, I'm going to use my crease tool here. So I'll activate it. I'll select the lips, the center line there, and I'll middle mouse drag to activate the creasing. And what creasing will do is it'll hold the position of these edges and verts better in smoothed mode. And once I start creasing, we'll see that I can adjust the positions of verts because the shape of the objects is going to change. So I'll crease that center line, and then I'll crease the center two edges on both the top and the bottom lip. I'll do one last set of creases on the inside corner of the lips, and then that'll take care of the shape of the lips. We see that we get a much more natural effect now, and I'm going to turn my attention to the eyes and use the crease tool there. I'll crease the eye itself, and then I'll crease these edges that sit above the eye. These represent the eyelid where it folds back into the head. Now, we can also use the crease tool on verts. So I want to get a nice sharp corner on the inside and the outside of the eye. So I'll grab those verts, activate crease, and crease as usual. And now we'll see that those verts hold their positions fairly strongly. And now we end up with a nice almond-shaped eye. So one more loose end before I start building the forehead. I'm going to grab this edge here and just extrude it straight up. And then I'll grab the vert on the outside and snap it to the corresponding vert on the eyelid area. And then next, I'll grab all the edges along the top of the face and extrude them straight up. So in both the front and the side views, I'll line this up. And in the front view, you'll see that I kind of spread it out a little bit so that it fans out. And in the side view, I have to move them pretty significantly to match up with the corresponding spots that I've found on the front view. The next step is to grab all the edges in the forehead and use my Insert Edge Loop tool or my Connect Components to add another row of edges. And I can grab that row, pull it around and move it to match my front view reference to give just a little bit more curvature to the forehead in that area. And then I'll grab these edges here and extrude those back. And this is going to fill out the side of the forehead here. So I can just snap that vert to the back, extends where the ear is. And I can subdivide this set of rows in a moment after I position it based on my front and my side view reference. Next, I want to fill in the skull. So I'm going to create a sphere and I'll put it into place and then I'll rotate it so that its cap is facing towards the ear. And then I'll just scale it a little bit in the front and the side view, kind of to match the head. What's really important here is the number of subdivisions. I'm just going to reduce the subdivisions until I get something that feels like it agrees with the number of rows that I have on my head. In this case, I'll do 12 on the axis and 8 subdivisions on the height. Once I've got that set, I'm going to go into face mode and I'll grab some faces along the front here, just where it's overlapping with the head, and I'll delete that. And then I want to reshape the skull, so I'm going to use my soft select tool to make the skull a little bit bigger in the side view. We'll see that the head tapers towards the face and the back is much wider. Okay, so let's attach these two. I'm going to pull the row of verts on the skull where it's going to meet the ear back a little bit just to be clear of the face. Then I'll go to face mode and delete half of the skull. And I can just mesh combine the head with the face. And I can start matching verts up. And we'll see there is a mismatch in the number of verts between the head and the skull. I just need to add some more edge rows on the skull to fix that. Since I'm going to do the ear next, I'm going to look at the side of the head and just create a little bit of an indentation right behind the face. This is going to help me seat the ear. The ear is really easy to locate in our reference. And it's going to basically extrude out from these three edges here, but we're not going to extrude from the edges themselves. We're going to go to face mode and grab these faces and extrude those out. And this will be a block that sticks out away from the head. And this will work on the back of the ear. I'll just grab the verts on the back there and push and pull them out to create the shape of the ear. But on the front, I need to merge these verts back into the head. There is no ridge between the ear and the face. There's a smooth flow from the face up into the ear that we want to make sure that we capture. And we're working extremely low res here. The advantage here is that everything is going to be quadded out very nicely. The downside is that it's going to be a little bit more difficult to capture the shape of the ear using so few points. And since we do have some triangles right up at the top, to solve that, I'm going to grab these edges and connect them. That'll get rid of both the triangle that we have at the top and the bottom of the ear. This will all also allow me to create a little bit more shape towards the front of the ear, which will be very helpful. Another reminder, though, we don't want to have a ridge at the front of the ear like you're seeing there. We want to pull these back in to create a smooth flow from the cheek all the way to the back part of the ear. And while I've been working primarily in the side view, I do want to take a look at the ear in the front view and make sure that I match it up there. The ear tends to stick out and away from the head a little bit more than people think it does. So you just want to make sure that the top of the ear is pulled out a little bit more and that the bottom of the ear sticks a little bit closer to the skull. So the extended cut takes this all one step further, shows how to attach the head and the neck together, create a proper blend with the body. It also reveals some retopology tricks for getting rid of triangles in tricky places. And most importantly, I go in depth into creating proper anatomy, which is extremely important when trying to create an attractive female character. So go to my site and check out the extended cut. It's a great way to support this channel. Keep me making more videos. So the end result is a totally quadded mesh, which will be great for animation, and it's also a perfect starting point for creating any other characters in the future. On another note, I'm looking for ideas for new tutorials. If there's something you really want to see, drop a comment. I'm James Taylor. Thanks for watching.